Welcome to another adventure with Getting Lost. Today, we're at Chinese Garden MRT station because this is one of the entrances to the place that we're going to go to, which is Chinese Garden. So if you exit the MRT station from the gantry and you walk straight out, you see there's a pathway here. Walk all the way straight. And, or if you are also a jogger, there's also a nice jogging track that you can actually jog around the outskirts of the garden itself. But let's just go inside the Chinese Garden. So the gardens itself is open from 5:30 a.m. to 11 p.m. But this is only this part of the gardens. Other parts of the gardens may open at different timings. The Chinese Garden in Jurong was built by the Jurong Town Council in 1975 to provide social and recreational amenities for the rapidly developing industrial town. Like I said, these gardens are actually built on artificial islands created out of the mangrove swamps that was around this area here. And Chinese Gardens is actually one of those national parks that they actually built in the heartlands of Singapore. The idea of a Chinese garden came about in 1968 as part of the concept for the Jurong Park, which envisions the conversion of mangrove swamps on the upper reaches of the Jurong River into a green belt with landscaped gardens, a lake, and open spaces. This is one of the islands, the first island that we're going to visit, which is the Chinese Garden. And it's such a nice day. And as you can see, poking out through the trees right in front of us is the pagoda, which we're going to walk through later. Let's look at the map. And these are some of the places that we will visit. Yep, on top there, that's where we came in. Okay, and then there's the bonsai garden, the tea house. Next, we will visit the 7-story pagoda. The 7-story pagoda, reminiscent of the Lingku Temple Pagoda in Nanking, is situated on a small hill in the garden. You can visit the pagoda and climb to the top. Unfortunately, this is a pagoda and there is no elevator, so if you do want to go up there, you will have to walk. So you just need to walk round and round and round, and on each floor there's actually a door for you to come out to have a look at the view. So let's head up all the way to the top and see what we can find. Let's just keep climbing up. And as you can see, mostly these material used on the pagoda itself is actually mostly concrete and of course tiles. You can actually have a very good view of the area. Here you can actually see the Chinese Garden MRT station where we came from, and we actually walk through the pathway where the trees are now. The design concept plan for the Chinese Garden was prepared by Yu Yuanchen, a Taiwanese expert on Chinese gardens. The 13.5 hectare gardens is modeled on the northern Chinese imperial style of architecture during the Song Dynasty and the Summer Palace in Beijing. And it gives you a very good view of the area, not only of the gardens, but of the HDB and of course the private condominiums all around surrounding the gardens itself. Let's just stay up here for a while. Let's enjoy the breeze and of course the panoramic view of the area. Lots of trees, lots of structures that we will visit later, like the some of the iconic features of the garden includes a marble stone lions, the 13 arch white rainbow bridge, the arch and main gate complex, the stone boat and tea house, as well as the 7-story pagoda. With lots of trees, big artificial lakes, ponds. You know, this used to be all mango swamp. The Japanese garden is built on an artificial island in Jurong Lake and is connected to the adjacent Chinese garden island by bridge named the Bridge of Double Beauty. These are some of just the small lakes that you have around the area. And in these lakes, of course, there are little small fishes and a lot of plant life. And look here, this wall here is actually part of the bonsai garden, where there's a lot of bonsai trees in there. Over 2,000 bonsai trees from around the region, China, Southeast Asia, Japan. And look at here, this is a wheat field. And then bamboo, just to add to the atmosphere. The atmosphere of being in a Chinese painting. If I'm not mistaken, this is a Suzhou style house and decorated with lots of natural rock, you know, trees and lots of bonsai trees. Just look at that. Okay, so now there are trees that they actually plant on the ground, and there are trees that they are left in the pots. But I do like this old style Chinese house here. And if you keep walking, you will never know what you'll find. Ta-da! Another courtyard garden. And this one with even a little waterfall and a pavilion. And you turn this way, here's some pine trees and another house. Look at that. It just is so picturesque. The garden itself, I think they have done very well landscaping and designing it. And then even the house itself, if you look properly, they actually combine modern materials together with wood fixtures to make this house. So basically, this house itself will last a long time and will require minimal maintenance. I mean, it's because if you don't look carefully, the pillars, you know, the roof, the floor, I think they are actually just concrete, made using concrete and then tiles and then metal also. Only the windows and all the decorative parts, some of it are actually just wood, but majority of it are actually modern materials. I mean, if you are walking along this way, you know, it can brings you into mind of you are being a old Chinese scholar walking along your mansion. You know, it just gives you that, you know, when you walk through it, it gives you that impression in your mind. Okay, and then you also walk through a little bridge here. Look at that. It's just so, you know, it's like you're a scholar, ancient scholar, and you are studying for your imperial exam, you know, and then you're trying to walk through here to clear your mind so that you can study some more. This is the impression I get when I'm walking through this area here. Or have I been watching too many Hong Kong movies? Or was it Chinese movies? I don't know. Nowadays it's hard to say, since Hong Kong don't produce much this type of movies anymore. Let's walk through another courtyard here. As you can see, there are a lot of bonsai trees around. You are practically surrounded by bonsai trees. If the bonsai trees ever become sentient and started walking around, and you know, you'll be in danger. But since they are just trees, you're safe at the moment. Okay, this is the entrance itself of the bonsai garden. As you can see, they have two replicas of the terracotta warriors there. Okay, they have a nice look at the. I like the tiles. You know, it looks so original to the time period. They even have two stone lions there, and then they have two nice trees just beside there, standing guard. You know, at the entrance there. Anyway, if you do like bonsai trees, this is a nice place to visit. Or if you would like old Chinese style architecture, perfect place to visit, you know. I mean, these type of places don't exist much anymore, especially in Singapore. You know, don't exist here. You know, it may exist someplace around, maybe in China, or maybe replicated in other parts of the world, but you know, since you have it here, you know, you might as well enjoy it. Look at that. And walk through some of the rooms, you know, let your imagination wander, you know, think of yourself as maybe some kind of a kung fu warrior or something like that. I don't know. Or if you want to be, you can start learning about bonsai trees and become a bonsai tree master. I mean, here there's a lot of examples for you to learn from. Anyway, this is another courtyard filled with bonsai trees, examples of beautiful bonsai trees. But I'm more fascinated by the courtyard itself, the wall, the windows, you know, and then the circular entranceway. Anyway, thank you very much for joining me for my first part of my Chinese garden adventure. We have visited the 7-story pagoda and also the bonsai garden. Just walk around and just enjoy the environment. It's just so calming here. Anyway, thank you very much. Please like, share and subscribe, and don't forget to join me for my next adventure. Bye bye.